Hello and welcome back to Linux Gamer Till I Die, a hopefully entertaining series of videos where I play some of my favourite games until I die, or beat them, but more likely die. Today I'm going to be continuing on with my playthrough of Layers of Fear. This is the second episode in the series, and in the previous episode we managed to apply part of the painting. I think we've got another 5 or 6 stages of the painting to go, but we need to find more things around the mansion to assist us with doing this. I'm not entirely sure whether the game saved or not, so we're going to cross our fingers and load up the save. I've got my controller, because apparently the keyboard bindings don't work properly for the Vorok keyboards. So let's load and continue. Yeah, we've made some sort of weird bloody flamingos. I don't know if it's reverted back to when that actually happened. Hopefully, we haven't lost too much progress. If that is the case, I'm going to make a point of not continuing after we've get the next part of the portrait done. I don't want to replay the same part over and over again. Is that blurry? Yeah, I remember doing this before. Okay, I don't remember getting kicked open. But I remember this. At least I think I remember this. I'm pretty sure that door closed, and somebody kept knocking on it. Oh well, we're just going to have to replay this bit, and then when I get the next part of the painting done, I will end the episode there, no matter how long it's been. It's a little bit annoying that it doesn't track my progress between painting. Oh, I don't remember the paint being on the floor. Nice.
This house is absolutely amazing. But those stairs. With that leg of mine, I think you'll have to carry me to the bedroom once we move in.
All right. Shall we go this way? What's this on here, by the way? It's just a book. There's nothing in there. Looks like rain on the floor. Maybe ash. we've already been in here before. Wait, is that... That was gone. It doesn't look like there's anything to do over in this place, so let's start the music. I need to be at a different angle for that. It doesn't seem to be very easy to turn in any case. Looks like it's been burnt.
Needed a jar and a plastic tubing. I siphoned gas before. I knew how it was done. I stuck the tube in a vein and sucked on it until blood filled my mouth. Then put the tube in the jar and it just kept coming. A taste of copper haunted me the entire night. Why didn't I think of a syringe?
That's a little bit creepy. What do you want blood for? Floor's melted. I don't know. Maybe we do that again? Doesn't look like we can get out of there. Oh, let's try it. There's up there as well. Oh, I don't know. I've never used one of these things. Yeah, something's happening. Stumbling everywhere, and I must declare I stepped right on her toes. And when she bumped my nose, looks like the room's repairing itself. I fell, and when I rose, I felt ashamed. Stumbling all around, stumbling all around, stumbling all around. The bed stayed melted. Alright, can we leave? Is that all we need to do in there? I guess we got the blood. Oh, we're back at the painting. Maybe I won't just save the game after the next bit. Because it's only been 10 minutes. that's weird. What is it? Some sort of pyre. Ah, it looks like this has been burnt now. What's that? Eight even now, lost alone, you deserve it, a grave for you. Finish it. And there's some static like. It looks like there's something living in it. So I'm guessing it's the rats. He keeps blaming for everything. Some blood. Right, I guess. Let me go out again. Looking a lot neater in here. Amazing what a fire will do. Doesn't look good. It's all chained up. Okay. I didn't like that vase anyway. No idea if there's anything in any of these, but I'm gonna give them a good look. Like that piano anyway. Does it look like I can get past it? So go somewhere else, I guess. A bit dark in here. Very dark everywhere. It's a bright light. It doesn't reach the corners. Whoa! But where did the door go? Oh. Is that always here? He's got a key on him. That's a bit creepy. Looks like bomb hit. Where am I now? Don't forget 9th of June. Well, I guess he's looking as lock thing. And no There's... Okay. How can two people who once loved each other so fully, so profoundly, drift so far apart? My husband barely speaks to me anymore. He just... stitters? In and out of his study, obsessively working on one failed painting after another. He won't even sleep with me anymore. I can tell he's disgusted by me. The look he gave me the other day, that pathetic, hurtful look. A combination of shame, guilt, and repulsion. I have come to realize that I have become a monster in my husband's eyes. It feels like nothing a woman should ever experience. Still, being the good wife that I am, I decided to realize my husband's fantasy. If he thinks me a monster, I'm sure as hell will act the part. Right. So she's gonna act like a monster. Bye, door. This mansion's getting very violent. Is there anything in this cupboard? No. You can let me open this one normally. Thanks. Another note. September 15th. More notes today, even worse than before. The sad part is, I agree with every word. Wow, that's a lot of books. Looks like we can get in there. And there. That looks like a corridor. Okay, something written on the walls, that's not good. Let's close that for a minute. What's in here? Oh, that's just a cupboard. And anything down here? Door leads to another room. Okay, let's go read the stuff on the wall. Cretins, blind fools, simple, ingrates, ignorance, blind foolish. Or blind fools. That's also horrific. That was there's nothing in there, but I guess it was important to see it. Locked. Is this door here? That didn't make any difference. I kind of did. What's that? It's like a painting, a photo of somebody. And there's a ladder. That just goes to the top of the bookshelf, I guess. It just got a bit lighter in here. Sounds like a phone. Going around in circles. Oh. Hi. Can I interact with you? Dear sir, if I am to be honest, I can't say your letter was unexpected. Numerous colleagues have informed me that you have previously sought their advice in this matter, and while it is perfectly understandable for a patient to demand a second opinion, I'd think 16 concurring opinions would be enough. Still, out of respect for you and your wife, I have examined the case fully and have to concur with my colleagues. Involuntary muscle spasms are not uncommon with patients who have suffered burns as severe as your wife did. What you refer to as freakish grin or an unnerving yelp, though many would find such expressions hurtful, could indeed be manifestations of nerve damage. The other symptoms you mention do not seem to be psychological, or physiological, but rather purely psychological in nature. Traumatic events can lead to stress, severe stress, and that is nothing to be ashamed of. As to your demand that we fix your wife, you have to understand that she went through. What she went through cannot be undone with one simple procedure. It is a long, arduous process that will require all your strength and support. Please feel free to contact me or my colleagues should you wish to discuss a long-term rehabilitation program. Yours sincerely, Robert Richards, MD. And that looks like it says another. Fuck. Something. I don't know if that's actual name. Am I going the wrong way? Should I go around the other way? I feel like I've traveled enough this direction. I shall continue with it. Can I sprint? Yeah, okay, let's try going the other direction, because okay, it looks like we found a way out in a dead end. Oh, restless memories. I'm hoping that's wine. Oh, not good. possibly not blood, but probably blood. I don't know what that did. Oh, okay. Lots of paper. Got rid of the blood at least. Flapping horror, be quiet. Constantly flapping, eating other rats. Right, so maybe he has bats instead of rats. Oh dear. I can't go any further. Oh. So there's somebody at a window. Every time I get close, it throws me back again. That was weird. More wine bottles. Hope is a mind killer. Nothing. Maybe down. Down it is. Abandon hope while you can. Good advice. In any case, as your lawyer, I advise you to refrain from any imprudent actions. In other words, don't do anything stupid. We still have a chance of winning this, believe it or not. I've gotten clients out of deeper shit than this. Just don't make it any worse. Lay low for a while and let me appeal to the court order. This social worker definitely has it in for you. We can use that to our advantage, portray you as a victim of the system. A husband in mourning, a momentary lapse of reason, an overzealous bureaucrat. Trust me, this is our best option. Considering what you've been through lately, I'd say we have a good 50-50 chance of a good outcome. But not if you keep trying to convince everyone that you've gone completely insane. No more outbursts, no more rambling, better yet, no public appearances whatsoever. You can still get your dough. Oh, doll. Yes, it means daughter. So we can still get our daughter. Possibly. Is that somebody there? No, it just looks like another room. Well, wait. It's so bloody dark. Mouse. I have no idea which direction I'm facing. Right, wants me to go this direction? Ah, there we go. The light. Tap. So why does it tap? Can we go from here? Oh. Silent floaters, they clog the drains. Fur in the water, no bass for me. Wow, that's a broken cabinet. That to be anything? I made it fade for a second. Okay, guess we go this way. That one's locked. Switch doesn't seem to do anything. Oh. A set of scales. And apples. Lots of glass on the floor, but doesn't seem like that's any important. Down here. Oh, that. It's like a load of storerooms. Another body borrowers feeding on me, driving me insane, too fast to cut out. I guess he has an infestation of something. This guy has no luck. And an empty room with lots of broken glass and dead ends. Well, I guess we go back this way. Oh shit. That's not a good state to be in. The sooner we get out of here, the better. Ah, let there be light. Down in the cellar again, I think. There's a piano. Wait, was there somebody in the chair? Didn't notice them. Maybe no more playing of that. Stuff is just disintegrating all around me. I have a sneaking suspicion that this guy shouldn't be trusted with lit flame. So many candles dotted around. Well, guess we need to hit the piano a few more times. Or just once. That turns the gravity off. Can we get to the back of here now? What happened? There's a light.
I needed to remove the flesh from the bone. At first, I was lost as to how, but then I sawed it off with a handsaw, boiled it, then put the bone in a mortar. I had to get one, obviously. This was not something I'd done before. Finally, I mixed the dust with some white paint. It made for a lovely undercoat.
Alrighty then. Can't tell, but I'm... No. I was spinning around and I couldn't see anything. But apparently, lights come back now. So the crazy bastard stole somebody's bone and... crushed it to make paint. Let's get out of here. Oh, we're back at the painting. And yeah, it looks like a fire hit. Not sure if there's anything appearing on that. Maybe some lines? I wonder if there's anything I can do about the mirrors reflecting upside down. Wouldn't have forgot to check that. I don't think there's anything new in any of these. Guess we need to apply the bone. Here goes nothing. Is that a chicken? I don't know what he's drawn. It looks like we're halfway there. Now, what's the note saying now? I hate even now, lost, alone, helpless, you always will be. A grotesque misunderstanding. Finish it. Okay. time to do one more thing. 20 minutes left of the episode. What if you fail? Then I guess we're gonna have an extra long episode. You there. Where did he go? I don't know if I want to go in there. I guess I do. It looks like melted plastic oozing. Now, these look like children's drawings. What that is. Probably melted wax. Yeah, there's a lot of kids' drawings in here. It's locked. That's brick wall again. And I know. Selfish. And he's drawn a house there. Drink. Doors have disappeared. All the doors. And she's got a steak and a trowel. Doors come back. It's a different door. Ooh, fire. Fire on a horse. And this opened.
No, that's not right. Try again. Don't give me that look. What do we do when we fail? We start over. You're better than this. Now sit down, and this time, let's make it perfect.
So... we have a daughter, I guess, and we are very strict with them in their artistic expression. Well, this isn't creepy at all. Hi. You have a birthday hat on?
Hey, what is that? Wait, what day is it? It's Sunday? You mean well, why didn't you come and get me? God damn it! You know how I get when I'm caught up in my work!
Happy fifth birthday. Sad face. I take it he missed it. And she did not take it well. That wasn't there before. There. Stood where it wants me to stand, maybe, kind of. Another painting. Okay. kids in marriage. Expect the unexpected. The Everyday Magic of Parenthood. A new book by Molly Pierce is a must-read for parents who are expecting their first child and want to create a happy, healthy environment for the baby. Well, this guy needed a lot of help with that, and there's a door in my way. Okay. The door is gone. Problem solved. Squeak, 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 squeak. What is this? It's the cabling for the light. Is there a light switch? Oh. It's been drawn on.
Sweet Jesus! Did you just buy half of the department store? Honey, you don't even know yet if it's going to be a boy or a girl.
Either way, it's going to have fabulous shoes. I think that's everything I can do in here. Another house. Lice, mice, bold, bloody spots, hair not mine. Where are the scissors? Right, okay. That's an interesting draw system. Not convinced it's the best of systems, but probably makes him happy. Up we go. No, we don't. Up we go. Right, we're back in a corridor. Looks like we can get through that door. There's a heart beating on the wall. Sorry, I should say it's a broken heart. Right. Put that on here. Maybe not. Ah, there it is. Oh, it's gone again. I guess I need to just keep chasing it until I get it. Wait, is that a note? It is, but I can't read it. Oh wait, it's already on there. So, What did that accomplish? I don't know. Maybe nothing. Maybe everything. This seems like an interesting structure. Can you hear me? More fire. So crayons. A bell. Near the blueberry bush by the Emerald Creek, there once lived a duck who was a bit of a freak. Not content to just splash away in the... I don't know what that is. Reeds? No. River? She liked tearing out hearts and chewing on livers. Yeah, I think that's rivers. Nice poem. A lot of thought and effort went into that. Can I go this way? Yes. I think a head came off. I think I should go down here first. I got an achievement for that, but I don't think that was a good idea. Well then, there's a chair. And there's a door. Let's go through the door. Talking behind our backs. Light the candles. It's an interesting bookshelf. Jesus Christ, there's crayons everywhere. Have we not taught this child to clean up after themselves? How are they drawing so high? Wait, this is the same room. Except now there's a lot more scribbling. And a lot more crayons. And again. And gravity's gone off. And there's creepy dolls. How did you draw on the ceiling? Well, I guess if you can turn gravity off. Well, that's nice, there's a sun. Next room. Ah. I brought a crayon through with me. Now all the crayons are gone. That's still a weird mess of books. Oh, and that door's locked. Oh, that's an issue. chill down my spine. Right. Okay. I don't like this house. I think you should redecorate with less creepy floating skulls or doll's heads. There's an unfinished doll. There's a doll having a tantrum. Doll sniffing its own farts. Turn the lights on. I have a feeling I'm meant to interact with this doll in the wheelchair, crushing the infidels. Possibly not. Oh. Little dollhouse. Catch you in midair. Okay. I see. Doll shoes went everywhere. I guess we go for this door now. Except it doesn't appear to be a door. Oh. Okay. Did I somehow go through the window? Well, I think that was a little girl. She went that way, and the lights went off this way, and I can't go that way anymore. And in fact, I can't go back the way I came. I appear to have one direction I can go in. Okay. As soon as I go around this corner, I look that way, this turns into a wall, and I end up back where I started. Let's go this way instead. Did I win? Right, can I go this way now? Nope. Ha ha, happened to you twice. This way or this way? Oh, let's keep going down the creepy corridor. Oh, creepy, creepy. Yeah. Alright. Okay. So that's the same scene when I first see her running, and then she hits into here. So I am going the right way. Yeah, you don't scare me. That looks like a staircase down there. This is a really small passageway, and I don't think it's going to end. In fact, I think I'm just going around in circles. So I guess I need to go. Yeah, you're creepy as well. Guess I need to go this way. Hail Satan, I guess. What's wrong, little girl? Oh, okay. It knocked me out. Well, that was interesting. I'll be back here. The room where the dolls were. Looks like that melted. Oh no, that's a tray. What should we do in here? Anything? Nothing. Okay, well, let's head back this way, I guess. I need to find something for my painting.
I had the most beautiful dream last night. I dreamt he came to me, embraced me, loved me, as he once did. But we both know that while I dreamed my silly little dream, it was you he really lusted for.
I see. Scribbly scribbles. Right, so I've got a nice normal corridor to go down, or a scribbly corridor. And let's be honest, I'm going down the scribbly one. Nice painting. Can I go any further in this room? No. I guess I need to go down here. Ooh. More fire damage? Looks like somebody's use a sledgehammer to destroy the walls. Alright, I can go through there. Not there. This is child's room. And that spells anything. Can't open that. I need a key. This is the child's room I was in before. Are those dolls on the wall a few seconds ago? I'll assume they were. A wind key. Cat. Fluffy fakers mocking me, lying between toes? Toys, lying between toys. No toys allowed. Let's see, let's wind this, I guess. The door closed. Kind of look around. Okay. Jack in the box. Spinning top. All the dolls have gone. That's never a good sign. Oh. Oh dear. This little baby, the night is star. Stars fade above you, the room goes dark. Mama used to come to tuck you in. Now she's nowhere to be seen. Hi. Well, that was fucking terrifying. And, I don't think that spells anything.
This was a special brush,
A
horsehair brush, but different. At that point, I hesitated. Will this really work? Fuck it. I was already halfway through, and besides, it's not like I can just put it all back and forget the whole thing.
Well, I think we chopped off our child's hair to use as a brush. Because of course we did. Well, that's horrifying. Let's get out of this room. And close the door. Right, can we go this way? Aha. Well, I am going to save my game after I do this. parts of the painting. Let's have a quick look around. Gone. Creepy things in here now. Doesn't look like I can open this anymore. Yeah, that's not good. Well, let's apply the paint. And now it looks like a flesh-eaten man. Also, the cupboard doors are coming off. Right, I don't know if it saves automatically when I do that. Let's have a look at the note. I hate you, even now. Lost, alone, helpless, you have always been alone, you will always be. Hoping a grave error, finish it. Right. Yeah, there's more dolls in there. I'm gonna go out this door just to see if that saves. And I'm gonna leave the episode here for today. So, let me escape. And title screen. So in this episode we found 3 more pieces of the painting. I've forgotten what they are. There was some blood, there was something else, and then there was his daughter's hair. I think we've only got 2 more cupboards to open, but there seems to be a lot more of the note missing, so maybe there's more to it than just that. In the next episode, hopefully we'll make some more progress and maybe put a bit more, find a few more answers to the questions that have been raised here. So until then, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye for now. See you again soon.